and raise us up. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, we ask pardon and forgiveness for all our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on you, forgive you your sins, and keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Holy and loving God, your anointed Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and with power, to bring to the world the blessings of your kingdom. Anoint your church with the same Holy Spirit, that we who share in his suffering and his victory may bear witness to the gospel of salvation through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Reading from the prophet Isaiah. Listen to me, O coastlands. Pay attention, you people from far away. The Lord called me before I was born. While I was in my mother's womb, he named me. He made my mouth like a sharp sword. In the shadow of his hand, he hid me. He made me a polished arrow. In his quiver, he hid me away. And he said to me, "You are my servant, Israel, in whom I will be glorified." But I said, "I have labored in vain. I have spent my strength for nothing and vanity. Yet surely my cause is with the Lord, and my reward with my God." And now the Lord says, "Who formed me in the womb to be his servant, to bring Jacob back to him, and that Israel might be gathered to him. For I am honored in the sight of the Lord, and my God became my strength." He says, it is too light a thing that you should be my servant to raise up the tribes of Jacob and to restore the survivors of Israel. I will give you as a light to the nations, that my salvation may reach to the end of the earth. Thus says the Lord, the Redeemer of Israel and his Holy One, to one deeply despised, abhorred by the nations, a slave of rulers. Kings shall see and stand up, princes, and they shall prostrate themselves because of the Lord. The Lord is faithful, the Holy One of Israel, who has chosen you. For the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. The message about the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. For it is written, I will destroy the wisdom of the wise, and the discernment of the discerning I will thwart. Where is the one who is wise? Where is the scribe? Where is the debater of this age? Has not God made foolish the wisdom of the world? For since in the wisdom of God, the world did not know God through wisdom, God decided through the foolishness of our proclamation to save those who believe. For Jews demand signs, and Greeks desire wisdom, but we proclaim Christ crucified, a stumbling block to Jews and foolishness to Gentiles. But to those who are called, both Jews and Greeks, Christ the power of God and the wisdom of God. For God's foolishness is wiser than human wisdom, and God's weakness is stronger than human strength. Consider your own call, brothers and sisters. Not many of you were wise by human standards. Not many were powerful. Not many were of noble birth. But God chose what is foolish in the world to shame the wise. God chose what is weak in the world to shame the strong. God chose what is low and despised in the world, things that are not, to reduce to nothing things that are, so that no one might boast in the presence of God. He is the source of your life in Christ Jesus, who became for us wisdom from God, and righteousness, and sanctification, and redemption, in order that, as it is written, let the ones who boast in the Lord. For the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. God, creator, redeemer, and sustainer of all life. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. It's a long way up here. A poem by Catherine Worth, and it's called Smell. Through all the frozen winter, my nose has grown most lonely for lovely, lovely coloured smells that come in springtime only. The purple smell of lilacs, the yellow smell that blows across the air of meadows where bright forsythia grows. The tall pink smell of peach trees, the low white smell of clover. And everywhere the great green smell of grass the whole world over. Smells are evocative. We're sitting here in this cathedral and we smell incense. And it brings to mind a whole range of experiences and memories and thoughts. Just take a moment and recall some of the important smells in your life, maybe of a favourite meal, or a precious loved one, or of a garden, or of a time of worship. But just take a moment to reflect on important smells.